Ready up? Ready? Tell me when you start. So, hi guys, my name is Song Ming. I'm sure you guys know me since we've been in the same class for 7 weeks. So, today my topic will be there is an increase in domestic violence in Malaysia. As a citizen, as a Malaysian citizen, how would you play your part on reducing it? So, before we get started, does anybody know what's domestic violence?
Yes.
It's not really man hitting woman. It can also be woman hitting man. Like, so first, what is domestic violence? Domestic violence is as the following pictures. In this picture, there's a man abusing a woman. I think it's a woman. But yeah, it's because of abusive relationship. And this is also a man showing fist to a woman. And for this case, the woman is hitting the man instead. But there's nothing wrong with it. Maybe the man is quite weak, so it's not dominant enough in the relationship. But let's move on. So based on the statistics, for in the US, women are victims. One out of four women are involved with domestic violence, and three women are murdered by their partners every day, almost three. Yeah. And one out of six women survived the attempt or completed sexual assault. And US children are exposed to domestic violence each year, which is 50 million children. So it's actually quite a huge number. And in every 9 seconds in the US, a woman is assaulted or beaten.
So by the time we're speaking right now, there are probably a woman and a kid.
So there are lots of ways to help victims of domestic violence. One of them is helping the victims to be economically independent. The reason why I say this is because most domestic violence victims, which is mostly women, they are being abused by their partners, but they won't leave their partners because of this reason. Mostly because of this reason. This is the top for one reason, which is they are economically. They are not economically independent. They don't have the money enough. They don't have enough money to support themselves in their life, and they probably don't even have enough money to afford a shelter or even food. So because without money, they are forced to keep quiet and continue being abused by their partners. And even if they leave their relationship, they'll either be homeless or maybe wandering around somewhere in the street. And next one, the next step of helping reduce domestic violence in Malaysia is by providing children with the proper education. So most children, they grew up in a happy family kind of situation, but some children, they are exposed to domestic violence ever since they are kids. So we should always be a good example to our children. Because they will follow our footsteps, like whatever it says here, your children will follow the footsteps that we leave for them, walk in the directions of love, integrity, compassion, and self-worth. So even if you abuse your wife or anything, your children are probably going to repeat the same mistake as you did. And the other proper education is through school. So school has to teach the children's ethic, moral, so that they can become a So that when they grow up, they can have moral and they have virtue. And the second proper education is through religion. So I'm sure everybody here has religion, right? I mean, even if you don't have, you still have proper manners and all. So yeah. But religion also plays a big part in delivering the proper education to children. As I'm sure no religion will teach people how to do bad things, such as except for that, such as raping or assaulting your partner. And move on to the third step. The third way of reducing domestic violence in Malaysia is through the organizing prevention programs. So wait, hold on, I'll get back to the question. So spreading, we should, the reason why we have a prevention program is to spread our awareness about domestic violence, because many people know about domestic violence, but they don't understand the situation and they don't really know what to do. So I'm sure prevention program is one of the best way to spread awareness and help ask them to help out the victims. And yeah, this man, everybody knows this man, the corrupted Prime Minister Najib. So, by organizing prevention program, of course we need someone who is influential, who has power, who is popular. So, Najib is the most powerful guy in our country, so I'm sure maybe he can help out. Yeah, just by paying a bit of money. Yeah. These are people watching the prevention program. Good job, Najib. Fight that. Yeah. In conclusion, I think everybody has their own rights as a human, so I don't think we should hurt each other. Instead, we should help each other. So definitely, in order to reduce domestic violence, we should help the victims to be economically independent and provide them the proper education and organizing prevention programs. Anybody has any questions? Thank you.